This video I'm making at this moment, I'm making because making a live stream about this subject may not be suitable for everyone. I have subscribers all over the world. So it may not suit everyone to be to attend the live stream, so I'm making a video about it, a short one. If anyone has questions, just ask them in the comment section and I'll be reading my email again. I've covered almost fully right now, physically I mean. So I'll be able to go right on with answering my emails. So okay, so now you know that. This video is about the collective voodoo that is conducted on white women and East Asian women. It's primarily meant for white women, so Caucasian women, but it's also targeted on East Asian women. With East Asian, I mean women from China, Korea, Japan, Taiwan, Mongolia, those women. Now, it goes like this. You present them an image of an ideal. And you keep repeating this image over and over again. Collectively, all the women born in that community, you do it throughout many communities, but every woman born in that community will grow up with this image. So she will develop desires and longings towards this image. So now, every man out there that resembles this image, she's attracted to. So her sexuality has been molded by the community. And this is something about female sexuality that men don't understand. It's molded by socialization. Men are also molded in their sexuality, but females are designed to be molded in their sexuality by their community. Men are more, I don't want to say static because that sounds too robotic, but men are more, I would say, solid when it comes to sexuality. So that's what I wanted to share with you first so that you can understand the rest of the video. So you give the women, or I said the girls, because they grow up as little girls, you give them an image of an ideal man and you repeat it over and over again. At the same time, you give them an image that's opposed to the ideal. And the image that's opposed to the ideal must be similar to the ideal. So let me say it like this. You give them two images. One of the nice guy, one of the psychopath. The nice guy, also known as a gentleman, which is an idol referring to Apollo. So you have the gentleman, the very soft, kind man that understands you and embraces you. That's an emotional need women have. And then you have the psychopath who appears to do that, but at the same time, he's devouring you. So you give them two images, one of the gentleman and one of the psychopath, and they have to be similar. So what happens now is because you give them these two images, they will have a hard time distinguishing one from the other because they're similar. Why do you do this? You do this so that confusion is developed in their minds. So you are deforming the minds of the women to be sexually confused. And at the same time that you present those two images who are similar, you also present to them another image that appears to be completely the opposite. So hold on, let me open Word and I'll show it to you. What you see here is what I've made in Word to explain this to you. This is the sexual triangulation spell or the collective voodoo that's done on Caucasian and East Asian women. But it also affects East Asian women in a similar way. So for this spell to work, you need to have constant exposure to stereotypes and projected images, means projected from the mind of the psychopaths that govern the world. So that's why mainstream media is so important, as well as pop culture. So here you see a triangle and you have four images. Now, let me explain it to you. This is where the girl or the woman is. This is what she's supposed to look up to. So you expose her to those two images. The gentleman, also known as the nice guy, and the psycho, who's a joker. And you label those as almost, how do I say, you label them as above the natural, as something so rare, something so heavenly, something so out of reach. So you have an image of a nice guy, or called a gentleman, and this image corresponds with the female need for emotional bonding. And then you have the psycho, who appears to do the same thing, but really devours you. So you pretend those two images, so now you have confusion already in the mind. Then you present them two opposite images. Those are both defective, but you offer them two other images who is considered closer to them. You have the incel on one hand, just the man who can't succeed to get a woman, at least that's the narrative. Then you have the bad boy who seems to get all the women, but he is self-destructive. So in this duality, the woman feels comfortable looking down on this one and very comfortable getting attention from this one. And if she manages to resist this one, she gets narcissistic relief over this one. So this image here is to provide narcissistic relief. And the only way you can get narcissistic relief from this image is if you have an opposite image at the other side. And the incel and the psycho or the joker, the difference is that this one is a failure in what he's doing and this one is a success. But they're both negative towards females. This one over here is codependent on females, so he's not functioning as a man. The same as the nice guy, but the nice guy, he has material resources, he has financial means, so because of that, he can compensate for his lack of proper masculinity. This one tries to compensate, but often he fails because he ends up in jail or he ends up in fights. This one compensates through violence, immediate violence, and this one compensates through collective violence, so the collective structure. So all these four images are of defective men. The two at the top are considered the successful ones, and the two below are the convenient ones, the ones that are considered close to them. What does this do to the mind? If you expose the female to those images with those narratives over and over again, the mind develops an aversion to the incel and attraction to the bad boy. But because the bad boy is self-destructive, because he's codependent, this will cause trouble, so now she wants to go up and she wants to find a good man. And then you have the confusion between the joker and the nice guy. So you don't present them any image of a healthy man, only of defective men. This one has to take all the blame to lead them to this one, which will disappoint or will cause them to become worse mentally, so that this one becomes a rescuer. And because the rescuer doesn't want to put up with the garbage that is developed by them being involved with this guy, now the Joker takes on the role as the savior and he ends up destroying the woman. And you see this sexual triangulation spell in movies. Why do they do that? It goes like this. This world is a system of compensation for men. That is what it is. Because those around the world are sodomites. They are in line with Satan, who is the chief sodomite. And demons, they are parasites. They feed off of the human energy fields, especially male energetic emissions. So the demons need to feed off of men. In order to do this, they need access to the men. And the best way for them to get access to the male population is through the female population. But they cannot promote natural male on female relationships, because that would glorify the Most High. So the demons, through their human sellouts, they want to use the sexual dynamic of human population against human population so they can exploit the male population and thereby retain their hold on the human species so they can play God over us. That is what demons want to do. So that is why you cannot promote healthy men. And why is this sexual revelation spell used on white women and also East Asian women? It is because in this system of white supremacy, which is the worship of Apollo, you need to have some appearance that everyone that looks like Apollo is trustworthy. That's how you trick women into worshiping the image of the beast. So for demons to trick women into worshiping the image of the beast, they need to have, first of all, women in an anxious state of mind. Now, they don't have to do much for this, because though the fall of men, women generally are in an anxious state. So demons don't have to do much for this. But what demons want to do is to keep women worldwide in a state of anxiety. Now, if you have healthy, masculine men, the problem is close to a solution. So demons don't want the solution, because the solution will end up with glorifying Christ. So the demons want the anxiety to continue. So the demons promote this teaching of whiteness. And for this teaching of whiteness to succeed, white women must comply. And also women with almost no skin color in East Asia also need to comply. Because if they don't comply, the scam won't work. But they cannot explain the scam to white women, because if they would explain the scam, it's all about keeping the human species away from doing God's will and to keep us in misery so the demons can feed off of us, you would have very few women who would say, yes, I'm into it. Because they would see immediately that there's no benefit in it for them, nor for others at all. So you need to trick them into complying with the scam. And you do this by training their minds to be sexually defective. So this is the voodoo spell, or the sexual triangulation spell, that's conducted on Caucasian women and women from East Asia. So when you enforce these images on them through media, through the education system, through society, through their idols, entertainers, if you do this consistently and with a lot of reputation, you will get a population of females who can't discern healthy masculinity. And once you've achieved this, now you can sit back, because now it's a cycle that repeats itself. Generation after generation. And the only thing the demons need to do is to make sure the human sellouts keep the drama going. So when you have the white female or East Asian female population of the human species, when they fall in this, it will automatically trigger the rest of the female population to either see them, that means Western or East Asian women as an example to follow, or it will trick them to aversion. And aversion means it will resist. Well, their resistance, which is a form of fleeing, also brings forth energetic pollution that demons speak of. So both the adherence as well as resistance will both generate negative energy that will sponsor and benefit evil spirits. So this that you see here is installed to benefit the demons, so that men, because the men are the target eventually, so the men believe in Satan's scams. And to make this succeed, you need to have a scapegoat just in case this one over here doesn't work that well. And that scapegoat is black men in general. Because this sexual triangulation spell, when its pollution becomes obvious, you distract the people with black men who are sex predators. Now, there are black men who are sex predators. And I agree that they need to be exposed so that they are stopped. But in this world, they use black predators, black male predators, as a distraction from this voodoo spell that they're using on the masses. Think like this. During the transatlantic slave trade, they put blacks in chains like these over here and worked on a local scale. When you transport them on the ships towards plantations, you could put them in such chains. But these chains are physical, they need to be maintained, so you need overseers and technical people to manage it. And you can do this on a local scale, but to put a population of millions and millions of people in such physical chains, it's not going to work. Straight up. So, when the transatlantic slave trade was coming to an end, due to many slave revolts, and because it became unsustainable over time, those that ruled the world wanted to continue slavery, but they wanted everyone now to be enslaved. But they couldn't enforce these plantation chains on everyone. So they went to the demons, and the demons instructed them to use the human energy field against human beings. And that is by causing a lot of anxiety, into the human population, which leads to heaviness. And now the human beings are chained by the energetic heaviness that is like a burden onto them. So they want the human species in energetic chains like these. Not physical, but energetic chains, so demons can have a grip on the population. So by having the women anxious, you automatically trick the men into their anxiety. And now, because the men are anxious too, you have a loop, a generation loop of dysfunction that guarantees supply for the demons and the world rulers that benefit from this exploitation. And at the same time, you distract the men with worldly delicacies like pornography or drugs or sports or whatever, so they are distracted from seeing that they're being chained. And that's how you keep the trust of the male population in that system of compensation. And capitalism is the way to do this. There are other ways, but capitalism is the way to achieve this. So, to wrap it up, this sexual triangulation spell that's conducted on white women and East Asian women, it's a global scam so that females around the world look up to white women or East Asian women, or to resist them, both where it's aversion or attraction that develops. It brings forth negative energy, and this keeps the cycle going. And now I want to highlight why they put those two images at the top, the Joker and the nice guy. Why not just the nice guy? Or why not just the Joker? Because if it would only promote the nice guy, sooner or later, you would realize, okay, but the nice guy is not that proper. It's just an updated version of the bad boy. If they would put the Joker instead of the nice guy, you'd realize very quickly that this is a creep. A very dangerous one. So they put them together and make them appear similar. So that the mind is always busy figuring it out. Thinking which one is he? Which one is better? While both are bad. So you do this from a young, very young age with women. This would be a mental blockade in their mind that will take years to get out of their mind, if it manages to get out to begin with. So I want to explain this to you so you understand what's going on. And all of this is to get a hold on the male population to follow the beast. So yes, white women and East Asian women are subjected to collective voodoo. And there are many corporations as well as state actors involved in it. So for the white women and East Asian women who are following my channel, who are believers, because I make these videos for believers, unlearn those images that the world taught you. Unlearn the story and the quote-unquote benefits that the world taught you about those images. Because it's all a scam to hijack and hack your female spirituality to use it to keep you away from doing God's will, to keep you away from receiving salvation, such you are dragged all the way to the lake of fire with the demons in their misery forever. That is the purpose. So, worship the Most High only, and be at peace.